What's up, everybody? Goombas are evil here, back again for another ZOLE tutorial. In this one, we are going to cover editing chests, something that kind of gives a lot of people some pain, and because it can be complicated, but it's really not. It's the myth is false. It is one of the easiest things to do. So let's get started. And if you haven't watched the first video, please go back and watch the first video first, because there's some information that you need to know there. Even if you just skip to this one, if you skip the second one, just watch the first one first, okay? So, how do you put a chest? Well, let's see. Here's the tile selector. Sorry, I didn't click the window yet. Here's the tile selector. And you see a closed chest right there, F1. So I clicked on that, and I'm just going to put it somewhere. Okay. So, there's a chest. Now, in the game, if you were to go and test it, if you open up this chest, you get 1 rupee. And that's what drives everybody insane, because how do you change that? What do you use? How do you put something else in there? So, that's what we're going to cover. So, on the top toolbar, you see this lovely little chest icon right there called the Chest Editor. So, go ahead and give that a punch. And let's put that over here. So, now we are greeted with something called a YX and an ID. So, what is a YX? It's just what it sounds like. It is a YX. So, let me get rid of it 1 second. And the way you can tell the YX is mouse over the window and look down here. It will tell you. So, right there, the chest is X is 1 and Y is 1. So, we're going to go ahead and enter that. You put them both as one number. The Y is 1, as you remember, and the X is 1. So that is how that works. The Y value comes first, and then the X value of where the chest is on the map. And ID. What the heck is this? Well, if you go on ZeldaHacking.net in the tutorials section, and there should be a an item list somewhere in there, with lots and lots of items, and I also made a post below that with even more items for you to add in here. Some of them don't work fully. ID, if you look there, the sword for the level 1 sword is 500. So you just push that in there. And that's it. We have a sword in that chest, so go ahead and save. Make sure you save all the time. And now, sometimes you come across a weapon or an item that was never meant to be obtained in a chest in the game. Like, in the game you would get it from the Meku tree, or some person would give it to you instead of a chest in the game. And when that happens, this game will freeze up when you open the chest. And that's a problem, because most of the items in that list will freeze up when you open the chest. So, what do you do? This is where another kind of a complicated part comes in, but it's really not in the least. This is what people think are complicated, or is. So what you do, real quick fix, is you go to launch, and make sure you only do this after you enter the ID and the YX into your chest. So you go to launch, and click on ZOCF, and you're greeted with a console window. So, and you're also greeted with this thing. We'll get into that in a second. Chest ID. What do you think that is? It's what we entered, right? You don't have to put the first 0, but I'm just doing that for consistency so that everything's 4 digits. So that was our chest ID, right? Ignore everything it says there, and then type a lowercase or capital Y. Oops. I like capital. And then press enter again. And you're done. You can ignore everything it says there. So, because if you're a beginner, you don't need to know that. That's just preventing the weapon freeze, so that now, when you open the chest, the game will continue and you will have the proper item. So that is how you do that. And then, once it launches an external application from the launch menu, you have this box here. So just press OK, and then it has to reload your ROM, so it's like closing ZOLE and then opening it up again. So that's that, and you have it in your chest. Now, I'm going to quick talk about a patch that will give you 30 chests, because the other thing is that you cannot make new chests. You can only edit existing ones that are already in the game. And there's not that many on the overworld, which really stinks. So Lynn made a patch up here in the patches section, which is really easy to use, and we're going to apply it right now. Click on patches, go to ages, hit 30 chests per overworld. It's automatically applied, that's it, no questions. You don't even have to hit save, I'm just going to do it anyway. But it's automatically applied. So now there are 30 chest data things on map 0 for you to use. And you saw that we already edit the chest, but if you go to map 1, and I put a chest there, see, you'll get something like this. No chest data found for this map. So, as I said, there are 30 chest data things on map 0 now. So, search map 0 and swap. Now, the chest data from map 0, that's the one that we had on map 0 that we actually edited, but there are 29 more sitting on there. So whenever you want to add a new chest, you can add up to 30. You swap from map 0. So if you want to go down here and you want to add a chest, you swap from map 0. That it can be kind of confusing, but hopefully you get it. And if you don't, then you can certainly ask me a question and I'll get right back to you. Just make sure you watch the first video first for information on that. Okay, well, that has been editing chests, and I'll see you later.